there.
Okay. We have to be just a...
We have got the most gifts that we have ever had up to 2 years. We have over 90 gifts to give away to all these recipients.
$10 gift certificate from Casey's. And the winner is Lois Bassani.
Lois,
$10 gift certificate. The winner is Victor, come on up. Digging for two at top of the bay.
And the winner is Orange Casolino.
Normally I would say, turn it back.
But you're not.
Two nights at the Cherry Grove Beach Hotel. And the winner is Judd Norberg Team Cultured Elephant from the Pines. And the winner is Vote at Three, Annie. Cherry's t-shirt, and the winner is Boat Lydia 20-foot trophy. Not here. You and the winner is, it's a $10 gift certificate for Casey's, and the winner is Lynn Tunderman.
Thank you all so very much. I'm so touched. Words couldn't express how thrilled I am.
We have another PJ from Casey's. And the winner is Peter Coriale.
I'm happy again. I'm so happy again. Oh, I got it. Oh, thank you. I got to get this. I need one for my nose.
$10 gift certificate from Casey's. And the winner is, all right, Misty Two. You don't shake them up, they're getting crazy. They're all getting crazy. I can see Lynn Tunderman.
I'm in charge of the raffles for all the winners. And there's going to be loads of winners tonight.
American flag from Fire Island Land Company. And the winner is Boat Act 3, Annie. Annie got it. Happy he won.
This is Laura.
You hear my lover? Throw his name out of that hat. One hat from Casey's. And the winner is Boat Act 3 JoJo. It's the Off Project flag. Fly it proudly. And the winner is Boat Why Not? $10 gift certificate. please.
What is the Arts Project?
$25 gift certificate from Joseph's Grocery Store. You can throw this up. You can go anywhere you want to go. This goes down to like maybe 12 inches. And the winner is Jen Sarasani. Okay, you can just hold that right up.
You sure my name is
Oh, this is nice. This is a fishing outfit donated by Captain Mike and his wife Lynn. Carlo. This is wonderful. The winner is Kate Murray. I hope you're here. Wonderful. She is here. From that, we go back to a keychain. All right, here we go. It's a wonderful magnum of white wine. I think it's Torricelli Pinot Grigio from My Spirits. And the winner is Boat Why Not? The person giving it is Next Wave. And the winner is Franklin Benjamin. They won't be I don't think so. You don't care. You're proud.
I keep on. I'm proud.
And here's another gift donated by a current champion, Mr. Peter Coriale. It's another bandana by him. It's hand designed. And the winner is Annette Antioch.
All right,
right behind me, as you can see up here between Lynn and I, is this absolutely gorgeous wall clock. It was donated by Chris and Lou of Lewis Clocks. Chris and Lou are right over there. They're sitting right by the pool table. Okay, it's a wonderful clock. Thank you so much. And the winner is Daisy May. I'm okay with it. Come on up. Daisy, you don't want this, do you?
Yes, she does.
You like it?
Yes, we do. It looks so good in our compound. Yeah, it certainly is.
Way down the coast of Jersey, all the fishes all look messy. Nobody started blowing up a swell. But you know the catch of winning fish, they go through hell. In Cherry Grove, it's all so lively when the fishes all go out to get a fish or find a telltale. You know the get a winning prize, they go to hell. No stone for that forecast will dissuade folks from crying out their skin.
Afternoons Fund on the 50-50, thanks to all of you, is $472,000. That's a lot of money. Of which $236 goes to the Dunes, and $236 goes to one of you tonight. Meryl is right here from Cherries. Meryl is going to pick the winner, and Lynn is going to announce the winner.
The Shapiro system.
The number is 720-6159.
All right,
Ross Benjamin.
Anyway, I was about 12, and my friend's father and my best friend, Beach, at the time, we went crabbing, and we got a full bushel bag full of, basket full of crabs, and we put it in the back of his bullet station wagon. We're on our way home, and he decides he's going to be Evel Knievel, you know? So he floors it, and we hit the railroad tracks, doing about 60. Basket does a 360-degree turn, and there's crabs all over the inside of his car now. So he slams on the brakes, pull over to the side. The son, Peach, jumps out of the car. I ain't touching none of them. They're going to bite me. So he walks home. Me and his father finally cleaned them all up, got them all into the basket, and we went home, cleaned them, you know, cooked them and cleaned them, and the next morning, Bob decides he's going to go get the newspaper. He jumps in his car barefoot, and guess what was under his gas pedal? We've got one.
Okay, Ross. That's Ross Benjamin with the crabs. Peter Corleone. Corleone? Corleale. Peter Corleale. Oh, come on up. And you have one too?
This happened yesterday, and it really is the truth. I was all by myself fishing out on the pier.
Liar!
That was stormy, very, very rough. But to go back 40 years, when I was a kid, we went to Rome, and I met the King of England. He was there on vacation. So he gave me a beautiful ring and said, never leave this ring for your good fortune or your life. So yesterday I got a fish, it was a striped bass. So Captain Mike says the striped bass has to be 26 inches to keep. And this fish was only 21 inches. Well, I said, shit, I gotta throw it back. So I took the striped bass and I threw it back and I threw my ring with the bass. Today we're fishing. Today, Marge was on the pier. We're there all day. We didn't catch anything. She tells Tony, hold my pole for a minute. Tony holds the pole. Marge is back there. He says, I got something. I got something. He brings up a beautiful wheat fish. So Marge says, clean the fish. I gutted the fish. I cleaned it. And the ring was in the pole.
Judy. Hi, Judy. Come on up here. Tell your fish story.
This is a friendly fish story because a friend of mine convinced me to pick up bait.
I know you're not used to anything like this coming towards your mouth.
Pick up bait for her, but she say with the south wind on the other side, they were whirling around in a little bucket, and all the fish jumped out on our boat, and we were running to pick them up, but we stepped on a few. So there's about two live killings. That's my fish story.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Hi, Bob.
Okay. This is a true story from quite a number of years ago. Upstate New York, my son and I were camping. He was 9 years old. I woke up at 6 a.m, went out in the spring fishing with $100 worth of fly fishing line. And I was catching bushes and trees, but I was learning. Later, he woke up and he said, "Daddy, I want to go fishing." He was 9 years old. I said, "Find some worms." And I found I had an old spinning rod for him. Wasn't good enough. He couldn't find worms. Went to town, got him a hook with a little rubber worm on it. I figured, what's he going to do? 9 year old kid, right? Gave it to him. He went out. I think it took 5 minutes for him to come back, holding the line with a 10-inch brown trout on the bottom of it, saying, "What do I do with this?" That was dinner. Thank you.
Thank you. Is Annette Angelano here?
Yes, you got over here.
1 minute.
I live.
Judy, did you notice how the men just almost eat this thing? You know, they're used to these long, hard things coming towards their face. You have to learn, it's not gonna hurt you, you just have to hold it closer to your mouth. You know, that kind of thing. So if I can have all the contestants back up on stage, Ross Benjamin, Mr. Krabs, Peter Corlas, with the ring story. Judy Dalio, who is afraid of the microphone because it resembles too much of a penis, you know. And Bob Younger. Who is it?
Annette?
Okay.
Alright,
it better be good. Stand right there. Stand right there. Up there. That's okay.
So I decided that I was going to go with them and fish in order to find a woman. So I go out on this boat and I'm thinking, what do I wear to go fishing? I don't know. So I go out and I buy a special fish outfit. I buy beautiful deck wear. I buy beautiful Kenneth Cole shoes, deck shoes. I get earrings, makeup, everything ready to go fishing. But I was not fishing for fish. I was fishing for a mate. So off I go on this boat with my friends, and we're going out, and this woman who's with them, who I kind of had my eye on, says to me, "Do you know how to bait the hook?" I said, "Oh yes, I do that all the time. I definitely know how to do that." And she said to me, "Okay, just pull up this live bait trap thing and get the bait." So I lean over, already I'm disgusted. So I lean over and I pull up this thing, and there are live fishes, little teeny fishes swimming around in this thing. So I grab one and I kind of try not to hurt it, and I put it on this hook. And she said to me, "Well, no, you can't put it on the hook like that because you could kill it, and you have to make sure it stays alive so that it wiggles and it attracts the fish. But I don't want it to be alive because I was a peacemaker, I was a hippie, and the thought of leaving this fish, so poor thing, on this hook alive was making me ill." So she proceeds to get the hook and like kind of dig it right into its eye, and the fish is fishing around, and I throw it over. Okay, thank God, it took
was not my cup of tea. I thought I would lay on the deck, drink a pina colada, look cute, and that was the end of it. But no, I had to take the hook out of the mouth. Well, the end of the story is that I decide that I am not going to put a hook or bait for the rest of the day so that I would not catch a fish in order not to have to deal with this fish. So we pull into the dock, it's all over, still trying to make an impression. I tell this woman, she said, do you know how to dock the boat? I said, sure, I know how to dock the boat. So she said to me, how do you, I'll back it into the slip. You get the rope and put it on the pole, no problem. So she backs the boat into the slip, and I put 1 foot on the dock with the rope, and I got the other foot on the boat. Mistake. So the boat drifts this way, one leg is this way, and the boat proceeds to go too far, and I have to make a decision, because now I am stretched between the boat and the dock. So I decide to pick up the foot that's on the boat, and I'm holding on to this disgusting barnacle thing, crabs, horrible, and I proceed not to be able to carry my own weight, and I'm sliding down into, now if any of you have stepped into this mush, it's disgusting. So now I sink knee deep into this disgusting stuff, and now I can't get out. Now one thing that an overweight person does not want to do is have anybody try to lift them. So there I am trying to look cute, up to my knees in shit. So I decide to stomp out through the mire, which I did, get back on the dock, and told the woman to go fuck herself.
That was a lovely story. And I take it you didn't get married from that. No, no marriage for you. Okay, so once again, applaud for Ross Benjamin Krabs. Applaud for Peter. Applaud for Judy with the walking on the fish. Applaud for Bob with the fake worm. Applaud for Annette. For Annette.
Yeah!
And the winner, did she get a trophy? Did she get a trophy?
She better get a trophy, I'm hoarse!
Annette!
Yeah!
I want to put the trophy in here.
You're welcome. It was worth the wait.
The total was $750.
Karen's last Thursday night cabaret is this coming Thursday. I will be here doing my last Jerry show. So come on back down on Thursday night at 10 o'clock. I forgot to mention that a while ago. And see me. And I'm just going to mix this. Feel lucky?
Yeah!
The winning ticket is 7206776.
Say it again.
7206776. Once again, you have it? We have a winner! Come on up. What's your name? Hi, Paul. 7206776, that's it. What are you gonna buy me? Okay, good. I'll take that all the cash, thanks. Ah, she got the money, girl. Well, you can't say that now. Smile at the camera. Wave your cash. Okay. We have, thank you very much, Paul. No, you keep it. Keep it as a super card. Tomorrow, remember, we have three trophies that we're going to give away for best fish caught on the dock, best fish caught on the boat, and best fish caught on the shore, the beach. Not this beach, that beach. So, I'm sorry? And we match. We match.
Today is the fishing tournament.
Oh, really?
Yes.
And can I come with you?
Sure you can. You can bring him too if you want. Come on, we have to go. These are my lucky hats.
Oh, you have lucky hats?
Yes.
You're looking for a lot of luck, all
see?
These hats.
Mermaid. This is the gay hat.
Very gay.
My southern hat.
Well, with all that, you bet I win first prize.
I hope so. Oh, it's gorgeous today.
Where are we going now, March?
Now we're going to boat Act 3, where the captain is, and that's the boat I'm going to be on. And I think I see Captain Mike. There he is, that's Captain Mike.
The fishing tournament organizers.
Yes. Captain Mike is up. And here we have boat Act 3.
And
Captain
Michael?
Mike.
Captain Mike.
Good morning.
Good morning, Captain Mike.
Rules and regulations and size of fish that I must give to she said, so that they get the right sizes.
How important is that?
That is vital.
It's for fish conservation. You don't want to take fish under a certain size because you want them to propagate and make more fishes for next year. So you want them to be able to spawn, so each fish has a certain size limit that you can't take any smaller than that size, and it's different for every category of fish.
And that's very important.
Extremely important.
For conservation purposes.
Is there any illegal stuff involved?
That's what it
that's
is.
The legal
that's
sizes.
According to federal law.
We feel so lucky. You want to see how
we're
going to
catch one of every one of these.
Uh-huh.
That's
our
fish is
going to
be
so
big.
Will it fit in there?
It won't
gonna hang
fit
out.
In this net.
Oh dear.
It's going to be so big. The boat we're going out on is she said, but we're doubling up with Inevitable.
And how lucky do you feel?
Very lucky.
What are you going for? What kind of fish?
Probably flukes.
Flukes.
If they're not biting, bluefish.
And where are you going to go?
I'm not telling.
It's top secret.
Top secret.
Ooh, tough competition.
You got it.
Not only do I feel lucky, I am going to win the trophy. I know it. My girlfriend got up at 7:30, first time in her life, to say you're going to win. So it's a good omen. By the lighthouse.
By the lighthouse?
Right, but that's secret. Don't, you're not going to tell anybody that,
no.
Are you?
Of course not.
Good. No one's going to see this.
What's the name of your boat?
No name.
No name?
No name.
And where are you going?
We're going to follow them.
Do you
we're
going
to follow Act 2 and get in their chum slick. Uh-huh. And just sit behind and catch whatever is heading up towards there.
And do you feel lucky?
We feel very lucky. We're going to win.
Ah. What kind of fish are you going for?
Big ones.
I don't know. Yeah, big ones.
Your pants off, we have to do a strip search.
All right. Peter.
For illegal fish?
I'm on police patrol, security, on weights in their pocket to stuff into the fish.
With all the fish we're going to catch, we need this ice.
You feel lucky?
Oh, we are lucky. We are very lucky. We're going to catch a lot of fish. We got all the right tools. We got all the right equipment.
I know you got the right tools.
Hey,
the
tools.
I want to find out where you're going.
What we're doing? We're all following. Oh, okay. We can't tell you.
Ah.
We can't tell. We got our own little fishing hole.
Okay.
And if we don't any catch any fish, I'm going to save a little fish market.
No cheating.
Well,
this is an invader. What are you doing here?
Boy.
No.
I don't have any way to get home.
No. Well, we're going
please.
Away. We're going out to sea.
I want to avoid a sink.
No, God, no, don't. We're just about ready to go.
Where's your fishing gear?
I love my poles right here.
That's your pole. And do you feel lucky?
I am lucky.
You're gonna catch something?
I'm gonna catch that thing. Hopefully a big fish.
Where are you gonna go for the big catch
That's
of the day?
Secret.
Oh, everybody has a secret.
Do we have enough nets?
We're ready to go and everything is ship shape here.
No frozen fish.
No frozen fish this year.
Yeah, you have a reputation, I heard.
Well, to uphold, yes.
Where are you gonna go for your
what do you
big
think,
catch?
G? Out to the bridge?
Yeah.
Down to the bridge.
Jerry Grove Fishing Tournament has officially begun.
Yeah!
We're on our way, bud.
Yay! It's official. The boats are taking off.
I don't know whose boat.
Where are they going for the fishing?
I don't know. They're going deep sea fishing. They're going out to sea.
Go!
Go!
That's the first. Yay!
Yay!
Yay! Yay!
Come on, fish!
Good luck, Gabby.
Oh. Are you getting any bites already?
Hey, no, no, no.
Mark, I got one! Wait. I got one, Margie! Oh!
Oh.
Wait a minute, Dad. Come on, baby.
Oh!
Mark yourself, get one, kill me!
I'm a protege! I'm a protege!
Peter with the fishing police here.
Hey, Marty!
I heard the fishing police was here.
What?
The fishing police was here, is that true?
That's right. And get the ruler, Tony, get the ruler ready.
Why did the police have to check with you?
Because they know I'm a cheat.
Do you feel lucky?
I feel lucky. I was lucky 20 years ago. I caught a big fish right there.
That's what you caught 20 years ago.
I'm a supporter.
The fishing groupie?
Yes.
The losers. The real fishermen would stay on the dock. That's the challenge. Man against nature.
Right here.
Yeah, well, that's true.
The dock is filling up with fans and supporters.
What are you catching? Seaweed? Are you doing it ready?
No.
Good morning, sweetie.
Seaweed.
This is very exciting.
You brought it in the pail from last night.
No cheating.
French toast, please.
French toast.
This is what you call. Wait a minute. This,
this is what he caught already this morning?
So far, it's
is
the
this what he
fish.
Caught already this
wow,
morning?
Wow, look at
oh,
that.
Oh, for dinner.
That's a keeper.
That's a keeper. Bye-bye. Several of them.
Oh, where the big ones are. Big one. Thank you. 6 foot one. You got me by the shirt, honey. How'd you let Ma and Dad out of your sight?
She's on the Titanic, you know.
Oh.
That'll take her right out of competition.
That's it. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
She's trying to learn my secret knots.
Uh-huh. Oh, there's a secret to that, too? Oh, dear. Oh, here they go.
Where are you going?
How big?
Hey, Peter!
As of 8:30, no fishing activity yet. Maybe due to weather conditions, rough seas. Mr. Wolf,
what
are your comments on the fishing tournament?
Oh, I didn't see it.
You didn't see it?
I didn't see it.
They're all going.
Am I on camera? Shall I pose?
Yeah.
With my hose.
I have no updates.
We did see Dixie.
I don't know.
Dixie in her fishing shorts.
You did?
And she looked like she caught a lot of goldfish or something on those shorts.
That's illegal.
Oh, it's illegal?
Uh-oh.
Well, she put most of them back. I think they were like more like a rainbow trout. That's what it was.
Rainbow trout?
Yes.
I have
the
to say
an
unusual
trout.
Kind of fish to come around these woods,
yeah.
Right? They're not usually found in Cherry Grove,
no.
Fire Island.
I have to do some investigating.
You do,
I think
yes.
You should.
Well, you should go out on the dock because
yes.
Doreen is out there. Yeah. Doreen is out there fishing up a storm.
No fishing as of 11:30.
Here's an update on the fishing tournament. I don't have an update.
Oh my, here it comes.
Here comes the video.
Here comes the video. You're something.
Yay! What's going on?
Not
oh.
Much.
We've caught a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. A whole lot of what?
A whole lot of horseshit and I got a lure. Does this count?
Longest
lure.
Maybe
I think that's a new one. That'll be a new category.
Special category.
And I caught a cold.
What do you mean?
I caught a cold. That's about it. You know?
How can you catch a cold?
Look at my baba. Look at my baba. What's it doing? Anything?
Nothing.
Let's see.
Look at my baba. Look.
It doesn't even caught any water.
I even turned my back on the baba and didn't do anything.
We've had a distinct disadvantage. Peter snagged his bag of bait and fed the entire bay. So there's nothing left for the fish to want.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you.
Is that true?
Yes.
It's
Peter.
True.
Peter.
Peter, look at that camera and tell the truth.
This sounds
they
like...
They lie! They lie!
Are you boycotting the tournament?
For what reason?
Well, you tell me.
Because
well, you're the title holder, and if nobody catches anything, then you continue being the title holder.
That's good, so no one's going to catch anything today.
It's a setup!
It's a setup,
but we have to see Marge about this. Marge didn't think of this one.
Come on, Peter.
Everybody in an itty bitty pool swam. Three little fishies and a mommy fishy too. Swims and a mama fishy swim if you can. And they swam and they swam all over the dam. Everybody,
oh my God, this is not gonna work. They're scaring them. So, but I might say, da da da, we're having a good time, but we ain't catching a damn thing.
I love her wiggle. Great.
You know what?
Great wiggle.
Those fish.
sucking up that tea.
It's Sunday. You have to use spaghetti on your loin.
Jewish fish!
They want what?
Jewish fish, they want lox.
It's Sunday.
It's Sunday, so schmear, a little bagel, it'll be good.
Well, I hear everyone's gonna catch themselves some fish.
I had the nerve to bring down a ruler. The only thing I'm gonna measure.
We're measuring other things other than fish.
Excuse me, you know,
crabs. Yes, that's it. We're measuring crabs that we catch. Nothing else.
Oh, dear.
Not even water in my bucket.
Oh, dear.
It's a very sad
start.
Situation.
It's very only sad. The beginning.
It's only the beginning. We've been here for 2.5 hours. Playing with ourselves.
Oh no, we haven't done that yet. Maybe that'll bring the fish up to the sea. Peter, you've done everything else today. Do that.
Sweetheart.
Play with himself.
Record it.
I just hope nobody's going for those.
Okay. We're in the back.
I'm with you now.
Here we go!
Looking for fish.
You go, girl. You go.
Junior.
Oh shit. I didn't get a crab. I got my fucking line stuck.
It's gonna be one big fucking rabbit pulling up there.
Are you caught?
Stuck.
Wow, how did that be?
And here's our fishing audience. Very excited.
I don't know, it looks like he's mixing sauce.
You gonna pop it now?
It's
pop.
I lost my good hook though. Oh no, I didn't. I got everything back. Oh, thank you. It's a miracle! Yay!
Alrighty.
Oh,
broken hook. That's an Indian's name. Broken hook. Oh, Bobby, that's so much.
Trying to redeem. Now the camera's here.
The camera's here. I'm back.
That's what it counts for.
I didn't bring you coffee, but I brought you something.
Thank you, honey. Snapple orange.
Good luck, sweetheart.
All right, take care.
Catch a fish.
Don't push me in the bag.
I don't know. Do they take frozen ones?
They need live bait.
No frozen ones.
No cheating on this dog.
Anyway.
Oh,
watch that cast. Woo. What was that?
I don't know what that was.
We gotta teach you how to cast.
See you later, hon.
A little snapper. You should have brought the cell phone down. Could have called if anything happened.
Anything exciting
happened. You're gonna ring the bell. Keep us posted, okay? Bye.
It's like I'm threading the needle, ready to sew a spangle on.
Spangle that fish.
All tight?
All tight, ready to go. Can we say we caught this?
Yeah.
Woo!
I'm here for 3 hours now. I'm still in the same position.
3 hours? I've already been here 5 hours.
This side of my body is getting a nice tan. This side is nothing. My baba is just sitting there doing nothing. It's just a wonderful day. I'm having a wonderful day. But I have the best company because those boat people,
they're wimps. This is where the real fishermen are. Not on the boat.
And we got our fans in the background. Wow. We're set.
That encouragement that we
have. This
team. Is the encouragement.
Party Talk team.
Go, girl.
Yeah.
Go, go, go.
Well, it doesn't seem like they're doing so well here on the dock. Don't believe that they've caught even a minnow.
Did you catch anything?
No, a cold maybe, but I believe that Peter caught the bait bag. And that's why they're not biting anything, because I believe that the fish are feeding at the bottom of the bay on the bait bag that's in the bay.
Oh, I've heard some big fish stories this morning. I don't believe one of them yet. These queens.
I don't know. I just came from church.
Where's your fishing gear?
I will find out.
No. Where's your gear?
Let me see.
How come you're not fishing?
I will.
Oh, you're starting
in 10
late?
Minutes.
Oh.
In 10 minutes. I don't know.
We hate fishing. We don't like fish.
Oh, do we have fishing? Is that for the doctor's fund? Oh, that's right. Cherry does a fishing event for the doctor's fund. I'm a stranger here. I'm only a day tripper. They throw me out at night. They don't like me here during the daytime. There's strange people here in Cherry Grove. I don't trust them. They're scary. They go out with boys.
Well, I'm right to go to the water and get some blue whale. I understand I can have one on the rocks. And maybe after that I could have a Bloody Mary. And after that, I could have something else, which would make me bait for the fish, someone at the Y land. And that's a quote from Lala. And you like my pussy?
Excuse me, could I have an update on the fishing tournament, please?
Catch this flapper.
Can I get an update on the fishing tournament, please?
No.
Well, I'm up to start casting my spell over the fishies and have them jump in my basket. That's what's updating with me.
Well, I still caught the largest one.
You still got the long?
I still got the biggest one.
Did you catch anything?
Minnows. I caught the crabs.
You did?
I caught the crabs, but he ran away.
Oh.
I couldn't get him in the bucket.
You couldn't keep a hold on him?
Well, I got him up on the dock, but I couldn't get the... Oh, my God, I got one. Jumped off the fork.
Pete, are you singing or what?
I did everything.
Come on, you gotta sing.
You did everything.
You gotta start singing more.
Update.
Hey, Marty. It's dry. Dry as a desert over here.
Why do you think it's dry, Pete?
Because I threw in the bag of bait. They're already full.
I've got a buffet table down there.
He's boycotting the fishing tournament.
Somebody's got something here.
Oh, yeah.
Turn around.
Come on, baby.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Was it's still on there?
Come on, baby.
The only thing you catch out here are the crabs.
Thank you for sharing.
And they are delicious.
Crab. Oh!
We got you a crab.
We just need the babes and the pina coladas. It'll be perfect. Yep.
God. It's what, 2 o'clock?
Yeah.
We're here for 5 hours. We've been watching my Bob do nothing.
Do absolutely nothing.
That's my fish story.
They're suffering from lead poisoning.
You can catch
Pete
them.
Has thrown so many sinkers in that water. It's like a lead quarantine on this whole area.
Did you hear that?
Yes, I know, but it doesn't matter. You fed them already.
Is that a true story, too?
It's true.
I'm not fishing today.
I've read War and Peace from start to finish.
You read a whole book because nothing else is happening.
And I'm waiting for Pete to catch
something. For something to happen. How many times you read the book already?
I know it by heart. Pick a page.
Yes,
I think so.
You think so?
We can get it.
Well, that's the problem.
But wait a minute, Doreen's casting. Oh, no.
Cherry Grove Dock calling Act 3. How they biting?
Oh, we're catching something.
Oh, no,
it's gone. No, there he is. Bring him in. Yay.
All we got was a small bass, about 6 inches, and we had to throw them back.
Nothing.
I caught about 10 crabs.
All the way by the inlet, there is no water in the bay. There is no water in the bay.
No. We were down by the inlet. Where everybody else was, where all the fishing boats were.
I haven't heard a thing about them. I hope they're getting a lot of fish so we'll all have dinner tonight.
You know, I just got here.
Yes, look what I caught.
Look what I caught.
Is that illegal?
It's a winner. It's a winner.
Is that a legal size, Brad?
No, it is, but there's nothing fishy about it.
I think Marge has made the biggest catch of the day.
I think Marge is the biggest catch.
Everybody's looking for the fisherman.
I have to stop fishing because I have to go start being a president again. I will be back at 4 o'clock to hear the biggest fish story that everybody can make up, because I'm sure that's what we're going to hear.
They're very optimistic, and they're hoping for sort of like a late afternoon catch.
Every once in a while, I think I see you, but I'm not sure, so we'll catch you, though.
What's the name of your boat you're going fishing with?
The Schmeckle.
Bait.
That's bait.
Now let's see what you can catch with that. Oh, we caught something! Oh my God, look at this thing! Whoa, Michael! What did you catch?
I caught the winner!
Oh my
God! I caught the biggest fish of the day!
What fishing tournament?
Well, I just ordered from Sayville. I think my fish is being delivered on this ferry. I'm hoping anyway.
Are you cheating? Is that what you're saying?
Cheating? No.
No, she's eating.
That's not eating.
Eating. Oh, I want an update on the fishing tournament.
Oh, ask Kate. I don't know.
Tony's calling in. Who?
Yes, and the winner is?
Yes.
You say Peter Coriale again?
Yeah. Oh, come on, Kate.
Come on,
baby. Come on, honey. Let's go. Have some fish. Get some fish. Bring it in. Have some fish.
It's gone.
What was it? What was it?
It was an Italian squid. I don't know.
Yeah, I caught them all. Bye-bye.
1 hour and 13 minutes to countdown.
Oh.
What is it? What is it?
Oh, shit. Nothing.
We're desperate now.
Desperate?
In the final hours.
That's it, babe. Let's go.
We refuse to allow this to defeat us.
So what's your secret now?
Now what we're going to do is we're going to put another weight on, and we're going to see if we can find the bottom a little better. Now all day we should have done this.
Let's go. This is it. A little pressure is good for you.
Please. Performance anxiety.
You know that. Let's go. Do it well. Come on. We're going to cheer her on. Let's go, honey. Let's go. You can do it. Let's go. Bring Mama home a big one.
Look, singing.
You're getting a close-up, sweetie.
Yeah, I know. A close-up of how I don't know what I'm doing.
Hey, not the chair.
Good chair. Watch your chair. You almost took it. Whoa! That's good for a shark.
I get what you said, and I didn't work. Fuck what I'm doing.
What
What is he doing?
That's your lure. You didn't want to do frowns this morning.
Hi. Hi, honey.
Put it right on that one there. 15 inches.
Just barely.
Gabby, did you catch any?
This is 17 inches.
We haven't been fishing all day?
No, I didn't have time.
And you're starting now?
Yes.
You have 45 minutes.
Nothing. Are you okay?
Don't give up.
That's what I said.
What you guys gonna do to Victor if he catches something now?
We're gonna give him a beating first, then he'll get the trophy.
Watch it,
everybody, hit the deck!
Hey! Hey.
Don't
right.
Scratch my boat.
Mommy,
I still know.
Hey, he already got a bite.
Good.
How do you do that? Can you just put it in?
No, good.
I need for Peter, little one. But listen, if I will give you snapper, and I will have no evidence.
No, snapper, you'll get the trophy. At least we want
to fish. What'd you get?
Couple of fluke.
Oh, more fluke. How big?
You think she kept in it? What do you think?
What do you do with the
other one? Just like, they didn't even get bait.
Oh, good.
How big is yours?
7. We got 2 15 inches and 1 17. Hello.
So you might
be. It's not a fish story. It's true.
We haven't seen the facts yet.
We haven't seen the fact. We have to wait for the official boat weighing.
We're gonna go shower and get dressed for the ceremony.
Oh, all right. I'm sorry, honey.
We have friends in here somewhere.
Oh yeah.
Started out crabbing.
Great.
There's more than this.
That's a natural marker?
Well, no, they change color on the water to protect themselves.
Wow, I didn't know that.
He just pulled it right out of the water.
Where'd you catch him?
That's a secret.
That's what he caught?
Yep.
Oh, he will have an evidence.
He's still moving, and he's still alive. He's all cut up.
Birds are coming in, the boats are coming in.
You got 3?
I got 0.
How big? What are they? Hey, everyone's catching fluke. Hey. Get back.
Okay.
You cannot go back to the water.
Who got that one?
It could be my idiot.
No!
That's
me.
Somebody get some water. Well, it's gonna be dead anyway.
All right, Doreen.
That one, Doreen.
Get back in there because that one's bigger.
How many hours to catch that, Doreen?
Well, for him, 5 minutes.
A latecomer. Here she comes.
No, I don't. That's I don't fish.
It was unbelievable.
The line just zinged off.
Wow.
Mike had to back down on the boat.
Everybody had to get out of the way.
Must have spit the hook.
She got it all the way to the boat. We didn't see it, but it was the thing. It was huge.
It was such exciting.
Incredible, exciting,
it was.
Exciting.
Did you take pictures?
That's a real fisherman. The thrill of the catch. You don't have to keep.
This is a true fact.
No, but you know what we wanted to see? We
wanted
to see
it.
Yeah. We don't have to keep it,
yeah.
But we want to
see it. You're right.
To see what it was.
All right, Wolfgang, get over here tomorrow to see the trophy winning.
That doesn't look big enough, though.
What, do we got a fluke there?
Nope.
Wait.
A fluke?
A
Couple of nice looking flukes. All right. Yeah,
it's
okay.
Gonna be very close.
All right, nice.
Well, maybe there's way more.
Well,
this is the third one.
And the girls are coming in with fish also.
Yeah, good.
Which could be bigger.
Good. But you had a lovely day.
Yes.
Anyway, right?
It was a beautiful day.
Huh? We got
nice.
This one's still moving.
She said, act three. She said, act three. No, I don't think she's on right now.
The white bucket Victor has been fishing, and the blue bucket is Doreen's fish.
Snappers.
Snippers.
Snippity snap.
Oh, all this tension is killing me.
I think we got something to add, Bob. A Doreen.
Could I get an update on the fishing tournament, please?
We don't need fish here.
I don't know anything about the fishing tournament.
I wish I knew.
No, not really.
We got a big one! Big one.
Yeah, let's see how big.
Nice size,
babies. Is that seven?
Smile for the camera. The weight, show
is
the weight
that point. A 17 plus?
No, it's 15 and a half fat. I think we're all in.
We handed ours in already. It was the biggest one.
Yeah. Get out of here.
It was a 14 pound bass.
Get out of here.
Didn't you hear we called it in?
No. Where'd you go to catch it?
Secret.
We went out to the inlet.
Oh, you're crazy.
You're not supposed to say this.
Yeah, take this.
Locations.
We already played it.
Yeah, now what?
What'd you get?
Oh, please. It wouldn't even match up to anything we got.
Oh, come on.
I just had a great big bite.
Ooh.
I think I might have lost my bait. I'm not sure. Oh, no. Ah! Oh! I don't know. The tension's mounting. Something's mounting.
5 minutes!
Oh no, I don't even have enough time to get another piece of bait on there.
What did I do?
Where are you?
Combination on fly fishing, bay pole fishing.
Oh.
It's a new technique, all my own. In order for me to get. Here we are. This is it. This could be the big one. This could be the big one.
It'll be as close as
it's the
whole thing. The
whole
thing, the big one is. That's right. So we're really not even competing.
Rob, you're still fishing. I heard you caught the 17 inch.
Yeah.
Full of baloney. We followed you. You didn't get shit.
Hey, wait a minute. Well, all right, my door's not here.
15 and a half. Is it a thin 17 or a
Oh, he's trying to scare the fish away.
He caught a fat. How come you were driving your boat
towards
Sable? What? You go to the fish market.
No.
You went to the village fish market, I know.
Hey.
I'm behind you.
You're trying to divert my attention. I just missed a fish here.
6 minutes.
Oh, that was a good one. That was a good one.
The fishing tournament? What fishing tournament? I'm gay. I don't know anything about fishing.
Is that the winner? We think so.
All
right. Wow, look at those beauties.
She's
not shy. She's a star.
Oh, I had the smaller one.
You got a 15?
I got a 15 inch.
Yeah. I'm going to go in.
I got another 6 hours sleep this morning instead of getting up at 4:30.
I don't know what's going on. I know Marge caught three, and they were all 15 inches, so she kept them. But we'll see who's going to win.
Well, I heard two, then I heard three. Now this one, you told me three?
You told me.
She told you three, I heard two. But you know what? We're never going to hear the truth. Never, never.
And what happened?
Never, never. Out here in Cherry Grove, you never get the truth.
They're going to start sending the fish over to the weigh-in now.
What is it, like 30?
We're going to weigh the fish now.
now it works.
Sure.
16 tackles.
Sorry, Bob.
First prize.
Yep, Younger was just over 3 pounds. We were just at 3 pounds.